Imagine this. You're handed someone's phone and you're requested to play a specific song from Spotify. Now, this is a brand you've never used before and you have no clue where Spotify is. You don't want to go through every single page and every single folder and every single app before finding the app. Neither does your friend, and there's an easier way out. Let's talk about that today, shall we? Now, there are tens of hundreds of interfaces on an Android side, but for the most part, some things are consistent. For example, almost every phone has an app launcher, except for Xiaomi, because they want to look like the iPhone. If you took a stranger's Android, how long does it take to launch the Spotify app? Let's find out. On the iOS side of things, it's more similar and more repetitive. So there's always a couple of pages like this. You have 4 or 5 pages, depending on how many apps your friend has. And if you're looking for a specific app, all you have to do is swipe down anywhere from the center, and there is a search bar. In the search bar, you can type Spotify, and you're on your way. No matter which page you're in, the moment you're unlocked and you're in, if you just swiped down, the search bar will pop up. In some Android phones, there's also the Google search bar. If you tap Spotify on the Google search bar, it'll propose opening the app. Not all phones have it. If there's no search bar, swipe up, scroll down to S, and Spotify is right there. Now, this tip won't revolutionize the way you use phones. You know, it's just going to save you 20 seconds, but you're making so much lesser decisions because you're more aware. And it's just these little decisions, micro decisions that make you fatigued. I'd heard this definition of an intelligent person, and one of the traits are that an intelligent person accumulates information that is not necessarily useful right away, but might be useful in the long run. Like, imagine this, if you're going over to France for a holiday or for studies, or you're just moving there, you might not need this immediately, but it's good to know how to contact emergency. It's good to know how to avail your insurance. You'll probably never need it, but if someone calls you and says, bro, I have this friend who needs an ambulance, do you know how I can do it? Well, you know, because you look these things up and you know these things. This HR guy from work told me that you're not going to fall sick tomorrow, but when you do, you're required to inform the company at least 48 hours since having fallen sick to avail sick leave, social security coverage, and so on. You don't need that information tomorrow, do you? But accumulating it for a rainy day, that's what the old book calls wisdom. Actually, since we're talking about tech, dictionary actually has a very interesting line about this. That's the end for this one, guys. I'm Joshua Bulata, helping you use your phones and your computers. I'll see you guys in the next one. And in that time, keep learning. I got this thing called a kalam. Kalam in Hindi is pen, but I think it's a Urdu from an Arabic word, kalam. Q-A-L-A-M. And I tried my hand at writing Urdu. It has taken me 5 or 6 months to build this. I started off with the letters, and then I went through months of writing things down with a ballpoint pen, some better quality paper, and I'm really proud of this. I mean, this is a simple thing, a 2 euro piece of bamboo and ink made me so happy. I was up until midnight yesterday, just writing away.